Good morning. I am Dr. Sayeda GS and I am going to take today actinomycetes and no cardia practical. So one keep it. Actinomycetes are gram positive bacilli. All of you know this is a practical, so we will not go in detail and I will take briefly, but this topic is very small, so we will cover some important points. It's gram positive bacilli chain or branching filaments, non motile, non spreading, non capsulated true bacteria which resembles fungi, form mycelial network of branching filaments. It is a soil saprophyte or normal human commensal. Its cell wall contains muriatic acids. Actinomyces. Some important actinomycete members are actinomyces, which we are going to see in somewhat detail, anaerobe, which is anaerobe and non-acid fast, causes actinomycosis. Nocardia, another member of this family is Nocardia, which is aerobe and which is acid fast, causing actinomycetoma and pulmonary infections. Mainly Nocardia causes pulmonary infections. Actinomadura, which causes actinomycetoma, which is aerobe and non-acid fast. Streptomyces, this is only a source of streptomycin antibiotic, which rarely cause actinomycetoma. Thermophilic actinomycin, which causes farmer's lung or bagasosis, which is due to hypersensitivity pneumonitis. Actinomyces, it is a soil saprophyte and commensal of oral cavity. See, you will see the differences between actinomyces and nocardia. Mainly actinomyces is anaerobe and our nocardia is aerobe. And this is actinomyces is a commensal, so the route of transmission is endogenous, means some surgery, dental surgery or something like that. And nocardia, it should come from outside. It can be through inhalation or subcutaneous. See, as I am describing the difference between the both, so you can remember easily. A Israeli species or other species are Neisseloni and Odontolaticus. Actinomyces meaning is ray fungus. What is the pathogenesis? See, it is a chronic Sepiority granulomatous infection. Sepiority means it is having discharging pus from its sinuses. Mainly what is the thing? All of you know, I have told just it's an endogenous, means it's a commensal. So mode of transmission of infection is endogenous and it's resulting from some dental extraction. So what happens is bacteria lodges in the surface epithelium and it grows in oral anaerobic night and it produces induced inflammatory response which causes painless hard indurated swelling with sinuses which drain on draining of this pus granules are seen. We will see that in detail in lab diagnosis. Spread to neighboring organs including the bones which causes tissue destruction. This is the pathogenesis, means endogenous infection and mainly producing painless hard indurated swelling in sinuses and which contains granules. This is the pathogenesis. Four types of clinical manifestations are there. Cervicofacial, one is, another one is abdominal, pelvic, brain abscess, bone destruction, disseminated forms and dental caries. So, you will see cervicofacial. As you can see in this diagram, is a painless, slow growing, hard mass with cutaneous fistulas, lumpy jaw. This is a main sign of cervicofacial actinomycosis. Another clinical manifestations are abdominal form due to spillage of intestinal flora. Intestinal flora is also commensal, which causes secondary After any bowel surgery or appendicitis, this flora are spilled in abdomen and can cause this abdominal form of actinomycosis, pelvic form, IUCD insertion. So, after this use of these contraceptive devices, it can happen. Brain abscesses, bone destruction after it causing infection to bone and soft tissue infections. Disseminated form due to hematogenous spread, it is spreading infection to lungs and livers, and which can be seen as a nodules. Dental caries and periodontal diseases. So we will move on to laboratory diagnosis. It's a very short topic. Specimen discharge is taken from sinuses or fistula, palp, bronchoalveolar lavas, sputum or tissue sections are the main specimens. Direct microscopy. See, what is done is pus is washed in saline and sediment is collected. This sediment is containing silver granules which are gritty, white or yellowish, less than 5 mm in size. These granules are crushed between two slides and a smear are made. See, all of you should know the different modifications of gram stain. Mainly it is asked in gram staining practical. You see, this is a practical. So mainly you should know the different modifications of gram staining. This is one modification, brown brim modification. It is for staining of these actinomycetes. See, as you can see, there are gram positive filamentous bacilli which are fungus or ray like appearance and having radiating peripherally with hyaline club shaped ends. So what you have to draw in actinomycete diagram, sun ray appearance like gram positive filaments, and at their end we should draw some round like thing which is of eosine color, means pink, means purple bacilli with sun ray appearance. And at their end, this club ends. We will see what is this club end. See, from the bacteria, protein and polysaccharides are contributing in this club-shaped thing. And from host, polypeptides are there. So, this is one sort of antigen-antibody reaction of this bacteria. So, club end should be of pink color when you are drawing the diagram of this actinomycetes and gram positive filaments surrounded by somewhat pink club or eosinophilic club. Direct detection from samples, fluorescent antibody technique or FISH, fluorescent in situ hybridization. In histopathology, eosine and gomorrhiz granules are seen as eosinophilic club. See, this is all purple in color, but these clubs should be pink or eosinophilic clubs which are surrounding the basophilic filament, that is blue in color, which are inflammatory cells. This form of structure is seen when you will take the histopathological specimen of this bacteria. Culture. These washed sulfur granules are cultured in anaerobic medium, that is thioglycolate broth. See, in this thioglycolate broth, two species can be differentiated as Actinomycetes strili. It forms fluffy balls at the bottom of the tube when it is allowed to grow, and boils form uniform turbidity. So, brain heart infusion agar. Small spidery or molar tooth like colonies are seen on solid agar. Biochemical reactions, mainly urease, nitrate reduction test is done. Gas liquid chromatography is one sort of lab diagnostic point. Molecular method PCR, RFLP is used. Treatment IV ampicillin, IV penicillin for 4 to 6 weeks. Oral penicillin or amoxicillin for 6 to 12 months. Alternative drug is doxycycline, ceftriaxone or clindamycin. And surgical excision of this discharging sinuses is the main treatment. What I was telling regarding practical point is modification of gram stem. See, one modification we have seen, that is ground brain modification, it is done for this actinomycetes. Another one is Kopelov-Biermann. In that technique, methyl violet is used instead of your gentian violet, and then basic fustian is used. In Janssen, if you remember, for your gonococci or gram negative cocci staining, one modification was there, Janssen's modification. In that, absolute alcohol is used instead of alcohol, and neutral red is the secondary stain instead of your secondary stain. Bigger stain, aniline xylol stain is used for tissue sections. Preston Moran stain, iodine acetone is decolorizer. So you should know the different modification of gram stains. It is expected in your prelims or your final exam, because whole your whole bacteriology and everything is finished in final exams. Nocardia. Regarding nocardia, see, all of you know there are certain bacteria, certain parasites which are acid fast, but they are not up to that much, they are somewhat weaker. So some diluted acids are used to stain it. See, all of you know the Zn stain, which are the main reagents which are used for Zn stain. First one is carbol fustian, the decolorizer is 20% H2SO4 in your routine Zn staining practicals, and malachite green or methylene blue is your secondary stain. But for this nocardia, it's weaker. All of you know Mycobacterium tuberculosis, it is stained with 20%, lepre is stained with 5%, and 1% H2SO4 is used to stain this nocardia bacteria. So it is asked in your Zn staining practical, which are another modifications of Zn stain, which other bacteria or parasites are acid fast. So this is one of the acid fast bacteria. So we will move on to nocardia. So gram positive branching filamentous bacilli, which are the other gram positive bacteria. One we have seen actinomyces, another if you remember Cornibacterium diphtheria. Then the second one is all your Clostridia, Listeria, Monocytogenes. See, these all things are asked in your gram staining practicals also. Name any gram positive bacilli, cocci, anything can be asked in your practicals. Aerobic and acid fast environment. See, I have told you the actinomycetes, they are inside our body, it is endogenous, it is a commensal. So only certain traumas or dental extraction is the route of transmission for that. But in case of nocardia, it's not a commensal. So mainly they are environmental, aerobic and acid fast. Their common pathogens are nocardia steroids and brasiliensis. Steroids are of star shape. Pathology, inhalation and transcutaneous inoculation. Inhalation mainly causes pulmonary nocardiosis. The agents are ansteroids, Ceria, C. georgica, Farsinica, and Pseudobrasiliensis. And for transcutaneous inoculation means they are causing or forming nodules, cutaneous and subcutaneous manifestations, and mycetoma, they are causing mycetoma mainly. And Brasiliensis, ansteroids, and rarely by otitis discavarium and transvalences. Pathogenesis, again person to person, it is not known that it is transmitting infection or not. On histopathology, abscess with extensive neutrophil infiltration and prominent necrosis surrounded by granulation tissue. Nocardia survive within the neutrophil by neutralization of oxidants. This is the main pathogenesis, how they are surviving. Prevention of phagosome, lysosome, fusion and acidification. These factors, see, one difference in infection by actinomycetes and nocardia you should remember is mainly they are infecting the immunocompetent patients who actinomycetes, but this nocardia is mainly causing infection in immunocompromised patients, that is a patients of HIV, hormone patients on corticosteroid treatment, on organ transplantation and tuberculosis, on malnourished or patients who are more for more time on antibiotics or diabetic patients. Means there should be certain predisposing factors for the infection by this nocardia, and the actinomycetes mainly causes infection in immunocompetent patients. So you should remember these two bacteria by their differences. Clinical manifestations, mainly pulmonary and extrapulmonary. For pulmonary, low bar pneumonia is seen, then rarely it spreads to adjacent tissues, pericarditis, mediastinitis, laryngitis, tracheitis and bronchitis. Disseminated nocardiosis, that is hematogenous infection, it causes infection to brain, skin, kidneys, bone and muscle. Meningitis is uncommon. These are subacute abscesses. Actinomycetoma is the main infection which is caused by this nocardia. Chronic granulomatous condition affecting subcutaneous tissues of the feet and hands. Subcutaneous nodular swelling is there, multiple discharging sinuses, discharge containing granules. Tendency of spreading to adjacent bone, bony deformities are seen. See, eomycetoma as is actinomycetoma is a short note. Eomycetoma means the infection is caused by true fungi, Madurella. And actinomycetoma is caused by filamentous bacteria, nocardia, actinomedura and streptomyces somaliensis. One more is botryomycosis, which is mainly caused by staphylococcus. Specimen, sputum, pus from abscess, these two are the specimens. Granules are collected in a sterile gauze or loop by placing the sinuses. On direct microscopy, like our actinomycetes, brown brain modification is used in gram-positive branching filaments are seen 0.5 to 1 micron thickness. H&E of the granules shows sundry appearance. These are modified acid fast staining diagrams. See, these are the acid fast filamentous bacteria. Nocardia are weakly acid fast, so we use only 1% sulfuric acid. Branching and filamentous acid fast bacilli. For culture, it grows on BHI and Sabra dextrose agar. 2 days to 2 weeks is the incubation period. They are obligate aerobes. Colonies are creamy, wrinkled, pigmented and adhere firmly to the medium. Selective media is buffered yeast extract containing polymyxin and vancomycin. Sabra dextrose agar with chloramphenicol. These are the selective media for nocardia. Paraffin bed technique. See, what is that? In paraffin bed technique, paraffin is used as the sole source of carbon. And see, one rod is taken. Glass rod is taken on that this paraffin media is put, and here the nocardia will grow at the intersection of surface of the media. Means they are pure aerobic or obligate aerobic. They will not grow below that air level. So you will see this growth on that glass rod at the intersection of media and the surface. Lowenstein Jensen media, moist glabrous colonies are seen. Laboratory diagnosis, non-motile, it is catalase positive, it utilizes sugars oxidatively. This is one difference between actinomycetes and nocardia. They are fermenting sugars, and these nocardia, because it's a obligate aerobe, they will utilize oxidatively the sugars. Biochemical test done for speciation, decomposition of casein, hypoxanthine, tyrosine, growth in lysozyme, acetamide utilization, growth at 45 degree for 3 days, acid from ramulin. These tests are done to divide them in species or their for their speciation. We will see differences between actinomycetes and nocardia. So mainly I have told you actinomycetes are not acid fast. They are non-acid fast. Nocardia is partially acid fast, that is 10 with 1% sulfuric acid. Sugar, just now I have told you this is a fermenter. Actinomycetes is fermented because it's an anaerobic bacteria. Nocardia, it utilizes sugar oxidatively. Actinomycetes are normal flora and causing infections endogenously. And nocardia, its usual habitat is soil and infections occur exogenously. Actinomycetes disease occurs in immunocompetent host also. Usually affect people with low immunity. Spidery molar tip colony and brain hard infusion agar, just we have seen. And fluffy ball colonies at the bottom of liquid medium, that is thioglycoid broth. In case of nocardia, colonies are creamy, wrinkled and orange to pink. Recovery done by selective media, paraffin bag technique and Lowenstein Jensen medium. Penicillin is a drug of choice for actinomyces and sulfonamide or cotrimoxazole is the treatment of choice for nocardia. Cotrimoxazole is a drug. In severe diseases, cotrimoxazole plus imipenem is given. Duration of treatment is for severe disease 6 to 12 months, for lymphadenitis, skin abscesses 2 months, for actinomycetoma 6 to 12 months after cure, for keratitis 2 months after cure. Aspiration or drainage of the abscess is the main treatment. Actinomedulla, cause of actinomycetoma. Important species Actinomedulla maduri and pileated tree. Granules are white to yellow except pileated tree, which are giving red granules. Microscopy of specimen containing granules are branching filamentous bacilli. Colonies are molar to tapirus after 48 hours in culture with sparse aerial growth like fungus. Speciation is on the basis of biochemical tests. Most isolates are susceptible to amikacin and imipenem. Thank you.
अपन पीपीट है
हो गए ना
अभी तक चल रही थी नहीं।